Literally yesterday, I worked on, I saw it came out, SBA, right? Small Business Administration came out with the ability for businesses that have been affected by this COVID-19 thing to apply for support. They did $8 billion, I think, was approved by the government. I believe it was last week, but it wasn't quite all able to be used yet. And so finally it came out, you can actually apply. This has created literally the number one business opportunity that I've seen from this so far. So for example, I'll give you, think to the past. Remember the BP oil spill? I had a client that was running there. They had a tax and accounting firm, right? And during the BP oil spill, BP was giving out, they ended up giving out $53 billion in support to people that had been affected. This guy could never grow his business above $200,000 in sales. Couldn't do it until the BP oil spill. Boom, sales went to $1 million in sales. Why? Well, basically, in order to go through and do these loans, you have to have a ton of different information to be able to do it. And so we would do all this consulting to get people all the information, how to get their tax returns, how to get their personal financial statements, among other things, monthly sales, and to submit to be able to get the support. That just came available yesterday. $8 billion so far, guys. And I mean, I would estimate that that's going to go up. So $8 billion so far for businesses in 10 states. And here's what I did. I actually worked on with my team yesterday, and I put together, you can see this here, I put together a full sales deck. Look at this. Well, first off, I'll go up here and show you all the instructions. Because I basically went through and did all the instructions, all the key links, every single thing you need to do to actually apply, and then the sales materials. Boom, 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 boom. You show this to a client, look at everything you need, all the process, how it all works, everything they're gonna get, and how does it work. And so, you need to be very specific about breaking out what is specifically related to tax and accounting versus what can you actually get paid to do the loans. You can get paid up to $2,500 to help them fill out a loan application, but you can actually get paid more than that. You just have to disclose it. So you have to be really clear, okay, how much of this is for getting their tax returns up to date, for getting their personal financial statements, for getting their monthly sales, okay? So I have prepared this. Not only did I prepare this, I also prepared email copy to send out, right? So email copy to send out to people. And so, we've sent this out to people from a broadcast perspective. We're also following up with multiple people doing all of our LinkedIn marketing right now. Guys, if you're thinking that, you can go through and just do the normal stuff, I mean, you got another thing coming. This has totally changed the psychology of the entire, world right now. And so you've got to change your messaging, but also you've got to consider changing your services. Now, is doing the coronavirus consulting the best long-term strategy for the business over the next 20 years? Yeah, probably not, right? But right now, today, this week, is this something that we need to do to, the biggest, most important thing is actually help clients, right? Actually go through and help people that could be affected by this. And so if you're interested in this and you want to do it, I basically set up a way for you guys to get access to this material. So you're going to get access to the sales materials. Okay, so those are the actual documents that you're going to use to talk to a client and sell these consulting services to help people apply for coronavirus business loans. And then the other thing is the actual marketing material. So the marketing copy, the email marketing, all the stuff you can do. I have also ads, advertisements in addition to just emails. And then additionally, like how do you actually deliver the service? Like how do you actually apply? And so literally I posted last night, I got this out last night. I was up till probably 10:30 in my Facebook group last night doing a video training of how to go through this entire slide deck. So guys, look, a lot of people think, I'll just kind of wait it out. Like I talked to some guy yesterday, right? Oh, I'll just wait it out like a month, kind of see where this goes. I think the likelihood of the effects of this being over in 1 month are pretty low. Now, that doesn't mean we can't go back to school in a month or go back to work in a month. It could absolutely happen. But you want to be mentally prepared for this to go on for 1 to 3 months. You want to be mentally prepared for this to go on for 4 to 12 months. I heard yesterday the president gave a press conference. He said he's looking at July, August, March, April, May, June, July, 4 months, August, 5 months, 4 or 5 months. That's a long time, guys. I mean, you can't just put your business on the shelf for that long. Plus, this is the very first thing. There will be payroll tax credits, okay? There is there's an extension of the tax deadline coming. All of these things create unique business opportunities. And if they're related to events specifically tied in to the reason why people are so freaked out and afraid, we can actually help people get their willingness to pay up and actually go through and transact. And so, I mean, look, at the end of the day, what else you got going on? What else you got going on? I mean, if you go out right now and you actually help these people, like go through the process, right? How you can take advantage of $8 billion in funding, get up to $2 million in loans from the Small Business Administration to get through COVID-19, right? What are you gonna do? You gonna work on that? Or are you just gonna sort of sit at home and watch the virus porn, right? So this will not be the last thing I put together. We're doing literally probably every half day putting out new materials because, you know, we're following all of the legal and the regulatory changes because they're massive effects to the tax and accounting industry, massive. So, I mean, there's just so many different things, so much money that's going to be pumped into the system. And all these accounting firms are going to be little conduits to help their clients get access to it, whether it be, you know, loans like this, whether it be direct cash payments, you know, whether it be payroll tax credits, whether it be, you know, extensions of the deadlines. I mean, there's just so many things coming on. So are you, you know, I had a client yesterday, had a client yesterday messaging so many, hey, Andrew, thanks for, you know, sending this out. Looks like my internet on my computer's out. So, you know, they basically sent out a bunch of my marketing messages and say, hey, my client said, oh my gosh, you're amazing. Like you're so on top of it. Let us know what we need. Let us know what we need to do. Thank you. We're just so busy and all over the place. And so guys, you know, most people do not know about this. Most people do not know about this that are running a tax and accounting firm. Most people do not know about this that are a business, okay? Some of my team members live in New York, right? In New York, that place is going crazy, right? New York is one of the 10 states. So there are 10 states on this list. I will list off the states right now, okay? The states right now, California, Washington, Idaho, Oregon, Maine, New Hampshire, Connecticut, Massachusetts, Rhode Island. What information do you actually need to get this done? Required documents to do a loan, most recent federal income tax returns, personal financial statements, schedule of liabilities and all fixed assets, and you need to go through and fill out all the paperwork. And remember guys, clients are gonna be competing for this money on a competitive basis, okay? So they're gonna be competing for this. This is not guaranteed to be won. Like one, you have to get them to work with you. You have to help them prepare a persuasive presentation. And you know, and then when you actually prepare all that, you send it over, there may be further inquiries that come back. So year-end P&L statement, balance sheet for the current year-to-date P&L statement, monthly sales figures, you know, if you wanna get a bigger amount. And so, and then also pricing, how are you gonna price for this, right? So there's obviously the $2,500 limit for the application or more if you wanna disclose it, but you've gotta consider, okay, what am I gonna charge for the business return if you have to get that caught up? What are you gonna charge for the cleanup if we have to clean that up? What are you gonna charge for the consulting to get the books up to date, year to date, you know, if that hasn't been done so far? So I've walked through how to price the business returns, the individual returns, the personal financial statements, all of the bookkeeping and the cleanup work to be able to get there, as well as the specific amounts you can charge and should charge for the actual application work. So guys, I mean, is this gonna be fun? I mean, like, look, there's all sorts of ways to approach this. You could just sit on your hands, pobrecito me, poor me. Or you can get a spear out and you can start going at it. You know, I saw a great post from somebody yesterday that said, oh, you feel weird selling right now because the economy's in this state or whatever, but you should sell if you can, because we've got to keep the economic engine going. And that's true. That's so true. Not just for, you know, the economic engine in general. What about your family? What about your business? What about your employees? Are they guaranteed not to have negative effects as a result of this? Are you guaranteed to have the same amount of sales in the next 6 months that you had in the last 6 months? Nothing is guaranteed right now. So in a month from now, are you going to be behind the eight ball? Or are you going to already have done $20,000 in sales in the next month as a result of doing this? And that's your choice, right? Work with me, don't work with me, whatever, right? But this is one of many opportunities. And are you going to be into it? Are you going to be out there helping clients, getting it done? This is real money. You're going to go into their bank account, and can we help them get it? And by the way, some of these businesses will go out of business. I mean, you think about restaurants, right? Restaurants are massively impacted by this. Restaurants don't have a lot of money to begin with. Restaurants don't have a lot of profit to begin with. I've seen a lot of restaurant owners saying, look, if this goes on for 3-4 months, we might not even be able to open back up unless something like this comes along. And look, I don't love it that people have to take on a lot of debt right now, but you know, when you have to survive, survival is first, right? You know, normal practices and strategies kind of go out the window when survival is the most important thing. So if they need this stuff to survive, then they need this stuff to survive. And so, you know, there's a lot of accounting, a lot of tax work that needs to get done to be able to get people to apply for this. So guys, is this helpful? Let me know in the comments. You can email my team. I'm gonna actually put a link here for you to apply with us and set up a time to talk about this and go through it. We'll show you everything that we're doing, all the marketing materials, all the sales materials, all the delivery materials. And then, you know, we'll also show you, literally, these are all the resources. These are all the resources that we've delivered so far to our team and to our clients specifically related to this, related to, you know, different things in terms of running the business, working from home, sales materials, marketing materials, actual delivery materials. We worked on, there's a draft bill that's gone through the House for payroll tax credits, where we have actually gone through and looked at, okay, how do you calculate these payroll tax credits? We've got a draft right now. We're waiting for it to pass the Senate. As soon as that passes the Senate, we'll roll that out as well. That'll be a tax planning opportunity specifically related to COVID-19. So you'll be able to find everything here. Go ahead and click the link above if you want to talk to me or my team, and I will see you on the other side.